Welcome back to more Game of Thrones coverage. As me, your father of dragons, and Spider-Man, with my three dragons, Bryonis, Chargon, and Reptaros. Don't you love my little three dragons? They're so cute. I bet you're wondering why I have him in the background. Don't worry, everything will be explained soon enough. With the coming trailers for Game of Thrones Season 4. I'm so damn excited for this. And again, I forgot I could do this now, because I can just express my excitement to you guys about various things. And I was, again, so excited that it didn't cross my mind, because my brain wanted to block it out for good reason. Oh, brain to treat me so good sometimes until you get me into trouble. Moving on from that, I am so excited for Game of Thrones. I love it so much. I'm starting to read the books now, so I don't really kind of don't want to know. I do want to know because I'm still kind of in the middle, but I've caught up on the show completely, and I'm a couple chapters into the books. So I kind of want to wait it out and maybe see. I don't know which is better. But honestly, after the debacle as The Walking Dead, I'm kind of traumatized because it follows nothing. But moving on from that, because we have more important things to talk about here, like Game of Thrones Season 4. What I have here is I have all three trailers reviewed. I took notes from all three trailers. I'm going to be talking about things that I found and hype around it all, so I can just basically go into the third and final trailer before the show comes out. So let's jump right into it. The dragons have grown up, and we can see... Damn. You saw how Drogon was flying through the city with his big-ass dragon shadow? Like, which one of you could do? You could. He could. He can fly through a city with a big-ass shadow and whatnot. Joffrey's still a douche. That doesn't change at all. Joffrey's still a dick. Red evil vagina witch bitch is burning somebody for unknown reasons. Yeah, I still don't forgive her for what happened during that season. Killed my other favorite character. If you haven't seen the show, then I won't say nothing, but he was my favorite other king. I'll leave it at that. The war always has two sides, good and evil, no matter what. Whatever side you think you're on, you better hope you're playing to win. Daenerys has a boss-ass throne room. I mean, it's like, it doesn't have like an iron throne or nothing, but it's got Dothraki soldiers and Unsullied and that black British chick and her, and it's like... Daenerys, what are you doing to me by torturing me with this awesomeness? God, I love Emilia Clarke. That's my wife. I don't care what anybody say. I'm going to love her to death. I'm going to marry her. I'm going to make her wear the white wig. Call it Danny and shit. They can live in my new world, or they can die in their old one. The first couple sentences, words out of your mouth are badass ones. Like... Daenerys is so ready to rule the city she's sacking until she can get to Westeros. But still, I'm so damn excited to see her face again. I just can't contain myself. Poor Tyrion. He's on trial for what I'm assuming is the Bolivar Trask and Sentinel incidents. That's not the same thing? Really? It's still him. Okay, apparently he's not in trouble for making Sentinels that can destroy mutants later on in the future. Silly me. He'll be on trial for something else, though. Oberyn is a badass, and I cannot wait for him. Because, like another video I had with my other friend Charlie, we were talking about him, and he's a badass, and he fights with a spear, and he's awesome. And, yeah, can't wait to see him in action, because apparently from what I've been told, he's got a big badass fight scene coming up sometime towards the middle of the show, so... Fingers crossed it's at least 8 to 10 minutes long. The Wildlings versus the Night's Watch. Who do you have your money on? First comment question of the day. We'll rehash it later. Alright, now we're going to go into the second trailer, which the first couple of seconds really confused me. Maybe you guys can breathe some light into this for me, but when Arya's naming Cersei, Joffrey, Tywin, and the Red Evil Vagina Witch Bitch, and he was like, what are you going to do? She's like, I'm going to kill them. Why didn't she want to kill Walder Frey? Due to the tragic events of the Red Wedding, why doesn't she want to kill him also? Leave a comment or tell me why, because that's personally why I'm really confused. Because I'm like, you were in his place technically. You saw him kill your bannerman and everybody else. And you already know what's happened. So how come he isn't on her shit list? He's already on my shit list, and I want to kill him to death. So please explain to me what that is, or if that's something I've missed, or if it's something in the book that I missed, but why isn't Walder Frey on her list? That's another thing. Poor Sansa, literally. I really hope she has some big character development, and I really hope she becomes, like, you know, like the princess kind of character, but, you know, I mean, she's gonna be in mourning for the majority of the season, I feel, so. I mean, I'm gonna leave her alone, because I feel bad for her. Daenerys is practicing for her future queen title by doing what she does best, ruling. Why not rule over complete strangers? Because why not? And because they love you, damn it. I will do what kings do. I will rule. Isn't that right, Spider-Man? That'd be awesome if I can rule with Spider-Man and my dragons. I'd be broken forever. Drogon got big. Like, he's like, I don't know what the hell she's feeding him, or if she, like, whatever, but he is growing so badly, and it's so cool. Because that scene probably cost them so much money. One of the funny things also people always ask me is how come they never show, like, the dragons more often, and I always tell people, I'm like, because to have a dragon or something like that on the screen is actually really expensive. So I know eventually down the line the dragons do grow bigger and bigger, so I'm pretty sure that's probably gonna cost more money. That's probably why during the last season they pretty much only showed Drogon or the dragons, not at all, that they didn't have to show them, because it's really expensive to have that kind of animation on the show, I'm guessing. So I hope that when they get bigger we can see them, but we saw all three of them together, you know, in this state right now, currently season 4. So I guess we'll cross that bridge down the line when they get bigger and bigger down the line, or at the end of the season or whatever, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. But they're getting big, and that's something to fear, because we need some GPS so that she can go down to Westeros and spy and shit. But yeah, we need some classic GPS up in here. Please recommend that to somebody. Who is this? That's what I'm saving him for. You! This is the second trailer we're talking about. You snowy bastard. Who do you think you are riding on a horse thinking you people? Who the hell are you? He even shyer than Spider-Man. I don't like that. Tell my viewers who the hell you think you are riding on that horse like you a people. You a person and shit on a horse. You frosty bastard. Alright, fine. But that's the one I wanted to know from the second trailer. Who the hell is this? Who is this frosty person? Who is this white walker on a horse who thinks he's people? I don't trust you by default, because that horse didn't freeze to death. That was the trailer 2 review. Now we're going to jump right into the most recent trailer, season 3, which is Secrets. Oberyn, I cannot wait for you to fight and be badass. I already love how he's got the mannerisms of, like, a total, like, awesome badass. Like, he's just, like, just the way he moves and the way he talks about stuff, and I can't wait for this show. I really can't. Just like classic Daenerys, you will answer injustice with justice. Because what else would you answer injustice with? You could answer injustice with more justice. So that's what we do for that. Dany has got some work to do sacking and practicing. If you know what I mean. That was his bad idea to do that joke, because he's new. I don't trust him, because he's a white walker who rides horses and shit. The dragons hit puberty, and it is so intense. I cannot wait. This season is going to be so intense. There's so much stuff going down. Just, there's so much of everything that I'm just so, like, it's going to be excruciating to wait every week. The really good thing, though, is that Game of Thrones is on an hour continuously, sometimes more, and it's on week after week after week. So they don't have to torture us. And those two things are why I won't kill people during the off weeks. And in case you haven't noticed by this, a lot of people were asking me, and I was getting a lot of questions about this, but I will confirm in this video that I will be adding Game of Thrones Season 4 to TV Time with Mr. Dark Phoenix. Confetti! Woo! But just a little something for you guys, because a lot of people asked me, A lot of people messaged me and asked me whether I was going to add Game of Thrones Season 4. Because you guys know I'm a Game of Thrones fan. But I don't think to that extent, because I didn't do any other videos besides the ones to do with my good friend Charlie. But, you know, as the episodes go every week, I'm going to try and do something a little different. Every week I have to see what's going to happen or, you know, what's going to go down with that. But I'm going to try my best to make different things happen. Maybe add other people, add another one of my friends that watches the show, and bring great fun to you guys. So, for me, your lovable father, your lovable father of dragons, and that White Walker bastard, don't you try nothing funny. I got dragons that breathe fire. Look at my dragons. They're so cute. Look at us. I will do what kings do. I will rule. You're covering my face. Thank you guys so much for watching this. Thank you guys so much for watching Game of Thrones and watching me talk about Game of Thrones. Don't forget to leave me a big thumbs up in the crotch bar and leave a comment down below. Comment questions of the day. One, who do you think is going to win between the Night Watch and the Wild Wings? Question two, who do you think is going to win altogether? I got my money on Daenerys, because she's Daenerys Stormborn. And question three, how badass do you think Oberyn's going to be? Pay homage that I have not read the books. So, we're just talking about show here. But thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to comment and leave me a big thumbs up. Comment, rate, and subscribe, all that good stuff. Tell your Game of Thrones friends. Also, I'm confirming something else just a little bit here. Before the show starts, or a little bit after the show starts, I'm going to be doing a little giveaway for Game of Thrones, so don't forget to stay tuned for that. I'm going to be releasing more information when I know more stuff, but I'm going to be doing a Game of Thrones giveaway for you guys, because I love the show, and I would love to meet new people, and all that good stuff. So, just a little tiny teaser for you guys. I'll have more information as it gets out. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Always remember, good times and bad times. Always remember to geek out and enjoy your lives. I'm going to find out who the hell he is. And I'm going to sack me some cities and whatnot. I need me some new stuff. Come on, Spider-Man. We're out of here. Enjoy, guys. Thank you so much.